What's the best joke I've never heard?
It takes 10 minutes.
Okay. What's the second best joke I've never heard?
You weren't recording that, were you?
Maybe.
Then erase what you just did. Because if it was picked up by this, that's not good. Erase it. If it comes out, I'll come kill you. I'll personally come kill you. So where do you weigh a whale?
Where do you weigh a whale?
It's a whaleway station.
The last time we talked on the podcast, my favorite part was when we were just talking shop about guitar playing.
Yeah.
I feel like you don't get to do that as much.
Let's do that.
What's the first thing that you play when you hear this chord? Can you tell me why you played that?
Because a flat six against what you played is beautiful.
Okay.
Violin minor against that C, whatever the hell it was.
C minor.
It's got a two in it.
Yeah. C minor at two, at nine, whatever you want to say. Yeah. So you say the flat six.
There we go.
All right.
So I do another chord.
About another chord. Let's try kind of similar. B is the root now.
It sounds half major, half minor. And if you go a major against major minor, you can go, but it doesn't sound right. I bent it.
Yeah.
Allman Brothers. So do another one. I like this. This is fun.
All right. How about
nobody's ever asked me.
How about this? So the G is the root.
Just a G9? Is that all it is?
Major 9.
Oh, so it's got a major 7th in it. All right, so you can go.
Okay, this is very interesting. This is what you did on the podcast, so if there's a chord that you're trying to figure out what to do over, you know, what you can solo over, improvise, what you did right there was kind of arpeggiate it first and then find your sort of comfort zone.
Arpeggiating chords, that's playing through chords.
Yeah,
that's,
I know.
That's it.
But the first chord that I played, you didn't do that.
Because I recognized it, or had it arpeggiated in my head.
Yes. So, there's certain sounds I find as guitar players where we hear a sound and we kind of dilute it to our most comfortable.
Well, you know, play the first chord again. It doesn't have to do that.
Okay.
The C. I don't have to use the minor six. There's a million places I go. Do it again.
I like that.
I mean, okay. Come on, that chord's like heaven for a guitar player.
Exactly. So now do the same thing, and I'm gonna play a couple different chords. I'm not gonna bail out of the key.
Forget that I can play guitar. I forget. I mean, literally,
you can make a bunch of guitars.
It's actually very interesting what you're doing because that is in my sweet spot. I haven't played guitar in so long. We went and did a tour of China before Christmas, and I'm basically, it's the last time I played, and I forget. I love guitar. This is beautiful. That was just good fun. This is heaven on earth. Repeated a lick, that's not good.
Well, repeating licks isn't that bad, right?
No.
If you think about the notes, I asked you this on the podcast, you started to expand on it, but I want to get your full answer. You think about the notes against the chord, or do you just think about a little bit of muscle memory, or is there a kind of blend?
I throw myself to the wind.
Yeah, just close your eyes.
Nah, I just throw myself to the wind and hope somebody shows up and helps me.
You're blown to the right spot.
Oh, seriously. Sounded so cool, I kept doing it. I mean,
like that's some out of the, some
If I had done it once, it didn't sound cool. I'd have got off it. But I liked it, so I just kept playing it.
It's like somehow the best guitar solos happen that way, you know? Like, they have those repetitive licks.
The best guitar solos are melodies inside of tunes.
Right.
I mean, no matter what you want to say about Smoke on the Water, the solo is an absolute journey.
Mm-hmm. I agree. Most people don't think of the solo when they think about Smoke on the Water.
Oh, God, it's
a mistake.
It's absolutely gorgeous, melodic solo, and he's playing through changes.
Yep. I got a lot of what you had to say about the amp you're playing through.
This is an MT-15. This is the first time that I've actually played through this amplifier. I let Mark and Doug do this.
Yeah.
I played through it a couple chords, but I've never played guitar through it. I really like this amp. This thing sounds like me. I like it. And when Mark plays through it, it sounds like him. So we're going to sell gazelle. We've already sold 1,200 of them. I think
holy
we're
going to. Yeah.
Holy cow, right. Holy cow. I mean, you wouldn't think a Mark Tremonti amp would sound like that, but that's a 15-watt amp, and it's doing what my hands are doing. There's a Hendrix thing.
Oh, yeah, man. Were you playing that on a G? There we are. And that's out of that pentatonic.
Yeah, so I'm playing it minor.
Yeah, like a little violin. Natural minor.
You can do it here, too. I spent a lot of time studying Machine Gun.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Okay? And the first chord of the tune is... But from what I can tell... He loved this chord, Hendrix.
So, it has that kind of like real slow bass and drum groove.
Well, it's actually, we swung it, which.
Really?
We didn't play it straight. And it sounds wonderful swung.
I've never thought to swing that tune because it's machine gun like rigid.
No. Well, that's fine. So the. Oh, swing it.
I'm just going to hear that song differently now.
Oh, we recorded it.
Who's we? Like
my band. We got permission from the Hendrix Foundation to record it. It's on YouTube.
Dang.
And I'll give you a copy of it.
We swung
three bass players. Wizard from Mother's Finest, Gary Granger from Schofield's band, and Kevin Walker from Timberlake's band. And they swung the shit out of it. And Greg Granger was leading the charge. And so what I did at the beginning of the tune was I slid the drums under the intro so that when I came in I was swinging with the same degrees of freedom, the same degrees of swing that they were when they played it, right? So I had set the groove up. God, what fun.
People can find that on YouTube.
Oh God, yes.
Okay, I'll put a link in the description for that. Yeah. Well, cool, man. This has been fun. Now that we're playing, I just
want to play.
Yeah. Thanks, Paul.
So, thank you very much. So, I'll tell you what. I'll play a chord.
Okay.
And you play. So I want you to think.
Can I turn on a little bit of fun,
yeah,
fun
sure.
stuff here?
Yeah, sure.
I don't know how to. I've never used this effect.
Try it. Okay, here we go. So, I want you to think. I want you to think E minor.
Guitar player's favorite key.
Yeah, but listen, this is where we're going to start.
Okay.
Play an E minor. The fun thing is you just stay away from the one.
Yeah. Avoid the root. That's an excellent lesson. Avoid the root.
Well, save it.
Save the root. Oh, save the root.
Save the root. All right, we did good today.
That was awesome.
Great. Awesome.
Cool. I like this amp. Very, very much do I like this amp.
Thank you.